Namaskar. We are presently discussing communication, effective communication, and different modes of communication. In the previous class, we have discussed different forms of communication, already discussed formal and informal communication. Let us have a review on that. Formal means a communication in which excessive formality is there between official colleagues, between peers and superiors. Written communication is enhanced, whereas informal communication, we communicate freely along with mutual trust, support and harmony. Now, today we are going to discuss the third form of communication, widely acceptable, but this is the most important way of communication in modern organizations. Let us start with that. Communication processes within an organization is characterized and molded by the nature of organizational structure. What type of organizational structure we are having? In the organizing part, we will study different modes of organizational structure. Some are known as organic structures. The word organic means flat structure in which one single person is the boss and lot many people are going to report him. There is no channel of hierarchy between them. But in a mechanist style of organizational structure, long chain is there through which you are supposed to communicate. So, the communication pattern is based on organizational structure. In general, there are basically three forms of formal communication within an organization. Formal communication can further be divided into three parts. The first one, vertical communication. Whenever we speak about vertical communication, it is either upward communication, that is, I am the person working as on a clerical level. I move to the principal level, that is from downward to upward. I am working at a lower level, I move to an upward level. Or it can be downward level. That means boss conveys some ideas, some thoughts, some orders to me. These are the two different modes of communications that comes under vertical part, that is downward and upward communication. Next is known as horizontal communication. This is lateral one. It takes place between my colleagues. When I interact with those persons who are working at a similar position like me, this is called as lateral or horizontal communication. Then comes diagonal communication. This is a very special form of communication in which I am the boss. I must not move directly to the clerical level, but what I do for a certain assignment, I start feeling that this is the most suitable man. Despite of any pay scale or work culture, I select that man, I move directly to him without following any hierarchy. That is diagonal communication. One very specific form of communication mostly discussed and mostly asked in examinations also, that is grapevine communication. In Hindi, we say angur lata. Grapevine communication, the word has been derived from the creeper of grapes. Whenever we see that creeper, it used to move here and there. There is no particular direction of moving. Similarly, in grapevine communication, there is no particular direction. We never know from where the communication has been conveyed. First, I would like to convey an example that what do we mean by grapevine communication, and then we will study this grapevine communication. In an organization, a transfer list has been typed by a typist. He has typed the transfer list and he has told the peon to take that transfer list to the boss for the signature. The peon moves to the boss, but meanwhile, out of those 26 persons who have been transferred, he studies 3 or 4 persons' names. He leaks that information to others. The order has not been issued about transfers, but all the persons within the organization know about the transfers and they start knowing that nowadays the transfers are going to take place. This is called as grapevine communication. There is no formal channel that has been followed to communicate it. Due to certain informal channel, the information gets leaked. This is grapevine. But grapevines are essential also. we get lot many information from grapevine communication. Let us study the definition of this word grapevine. This is informal communication. It is not controlled by management, or we can say management cannot control grapevine communication because it is a must. Secondly, perceived by most of the employees as being most believable and reliable than formal communications. In formal communication, we only get the desired information, but in grapevine, we used to study all other facets other than the formal communication. In news channels, in media, we frequently see about grapevine communication. We have seen Vishwasta Sutron se pata chala. What is that? That is all about grapevine. We have seen filmy gossips. What is that gossip? It is all about grapevine communication. Sometimes it is correct, sometimes it is not correct. Largely, it is used to serve the self-interests of those people who are using it. Certain people use it to serve the self-interests of themselves. This is also an important facet of grapevine. It results from desire for information about important situations. Something important is going to take place, then there is some grapevine. Sunne mein aaya hai, somebody has heard. It starts with, don't speak it to anyone. Do you know? Have you come to know about it? What is your perception? Please don't say. These all are the hooks that are usually used while giving grapevine communication. It creates ambiguous conditions within the organization. Nobody states that this is correct information, but even though people believe in grapevine, and this causes anxiety within the institution, unnecessary anxiety. Therefore, the task of top management is to enhance that grapevine communication that is creating a positive impact on the organization. Suppose I want to create some need within my institutional members, that is need for the university. Today I want to change my college to the university. What I will do? I will make a grapevine communication from my near and dear ones. I will state all the people that now our college is going to become a university. I will get a feedback from each and every individual that what they think about this particular thing, whether they are willing to change or not. Whenever I try to change the work culture of my organization, I use grapevine. Through grapevine, I float the message that we are going to do this, or we are going to take help from a consultant. Now let the response should come. Grapevine is mostly used by management to take the feedback from the lower and near staff. Forms of communication we are discussing, interpersonal communications. Why we need interpersonal communication? Why oral communication is treated as the best communication style? Because I am conveying one to one. Whenever the communication is one to one, it is the best one, because we understand all the worldly meanings and above all the emotions that are there within an individual. So why oral communication is so important? There are certain advantages of verbal communication. It promotes prompt feedback. The word prompt feedback means I get a feedback from the person's eyes also. One of my friends was working in Saudi Arabia in a girls' college. He told me, my dear, I am not able to understand that what girls are understanding from my lecture. I asked, my dear, why you are not able to understand? He said, all the girls are busy in wearing burqa. I do not get the real feedback from those girls. That means the curtain is there between that man and the students. How the feedback can be conveyed? So, whenever it is verbal communication, one-to-one, face-to-face conversation, it creates prompt feedback from an individual. So, the verbal communication provides you prompt feedback and interchange in the form of verbal questions and responses. I ask you whether you have understood or not. Simple feedback is given. It creates effective understanding. Secondly, it is easy to use and can be done with little preparation. I do not need to prepare a lot while communicating my thoughts to my seniors or my juniors, because it's a verbal communication. Easily I can convey. But it has certain disadvantages. It suffers from problems of inaccuracy in meaning and details. When it is on paper, everything should be accurate. Everything should be based on research. But when we convey, it is not so. Secondly, it leaves no time for thought and consideration, and no permanent record is there that what has been said. record has not been maintained. That these are the two disadvantages of verbal, that is oral communication. Now comes written communication. We usually write something in for the sake of communication, that is memorandums, letters, circulars, notes, reports, and there are other methods also in which the written word is used to transmit the meaning. Certain hooks I usually use while letter writing, pressy writing, report writing, everything is under written communication. It is really very accurate, and let us discuss the advantages of written communication. Very accurate and leaves a permanent record of the exchange. That means record can be maintained by written communication. Everything is on paper. We came to know about an important fact. Whenever companies go for ISO certification, written documentation is the must. Whatsoever you are doing, it can be informal also, but even though you need to provide a record because you are a certified company. Therefore, record maintenance is very important, and that is only possible while written communication. It leaves for thought and consideration and can be taken care of while referencing. We can take a reference of that also. That means whenever I feel I can take a reference, it is there in my record. Thirdly, it is easy to use and can be done with little preparation. If I want to convey a message to all the persons in my organization, size of my organization is 1000 persons working within the institution. Verbal communication, that is merely oral communication, is not useful. Can I convey everybody orally? It's not possible. In wedding ceremonies, why there are cards? Only to tell them that this is the record, you are supposed to be there at this time. We cannot convey everybody verbally. That's why written communication is important. But there are certain disadvantages also. Quick feedback is not there. That means inhibits feedback and interchange due to burden of the process of preparing a physical document. The person is busy in preparing a document, and therefore a quick feedback is not there. I cannot think about quick feedback while writing. And secondly, considerable delay can occur in clarifying the message meanings. Sometimes I have said something, the person understands something else because style of writing differs. I am a manager. I am having wonderful writing skills. When I am evaluating the performance of my colleague, I will say, Mr. Suresh is a wonderful performer, really a marvelous person to work with. I really like him a lot. I know this terminology. The second colleague, who is also praising the performance of second person, he says, Suresh is a good person and works very hard. Full stop. Now what to do? Therefore, it creates some problems also. Now let us study the communication in networks and work teams. What do we mean by this word communication network? We are going to study it in detail also, but just a single definition. What do we mean by the network? The pattern through which the members of a group or team communicate with one another. This is called as communication network. There are basically five types of networks. Just now we are going to deal with them also. The research has suggested when the group's task is simple and routine. When I am doing a simple job, routine job, centralized networks are really very good. They perform with the greatest efficiency and accuracy. Whereas when the group's task is complex and non-routine job has to be taken care of, the decentralized networks with open communication that foster interaction and exchange of relevant information tends to be more effective and really wonderful. This is the importance of networks. Let us study what do we mean by these networks. Friends, on a screen you can see five different types of communication networks. The first three, that is wheel, Y and chain, these three are formal networks, whereas circle and all channel network, that is star network, they are informal networking channels. Let us understand them one by one. You can see wheel on your screen. There are five numbers, 1 to 5. In the center you see 1. 1 is the person who is the boss, who is the central authority. 2, 3, 4 and 5 can directly convey their message to 1. But 2, 3, 4 and 5 cannot directly interact with one another. This is a centralized style of communication. That means only one person you are supposed to convey your thoughts, that is number one. If I am at number two, I cannot convey my regards, I cannot convey my message to number three, four or five. I am only willing to communicate to number one, that is my boss. The second network you can see, it is also a highly formal network that is called as Y. In this Y case, one is the boss, he interacts with two, three, four and five. But in this case, it is different than wheel network. In Y, if number three is willing to come to me, he cannot come to me directly because I am at number one. If he wants to come to me, first of all, he must report number two. And when number two is satisfied with him, then only he can come to me. That means one person at one side, I am having a hierarchy of two, three. But at second side, four and five can directly come to me. You can see in this Y network, 4 and 5 cannot directly talk to 2 and 3. This means, once again, centralized decision making and centralized communication process. We should move to number third. This is the most simple communication network, that is the chain network. In a chain, just like a chain, we have said that 1 to 5 numbers are there. I am working at number 1, I am the boss. This is a clear-cut hierarchy in which 5 is supposed to move to number 4. He cannot directly go to number 3. The 4 cannot move directly to 2. He is supposed to move to number 3rd first. That means there is a straight chain. Direct communication is avoided and only centralized communication is the walk of life. That's what we should try to evaluate. So these are the first three only concerned about formal communication. Very important. In those organizations where information is very important, like military, police, you cannot speak about the information to everyone. This is not a firm of chartered accountants. That means if some information is being leaked, it will create unnecessary trouble. So, information should be percolated to one single or simple perspective only. That is the thing in this. Then comes two networks. They are informal in nature. The first one is circle network. In circle network, one, I am the boss. I will deal with 2 and 5, but 3 and 4 are supposed to come to me through channels. They cannot interact within. That means 2 cannot directly interact with 5. Once again, somewhat decentralization is there. All the 5 are mutually connected, but not directly. Last is the star network. Whenever, wherever you see the star network, you will feel that organization possesses mutual trust, support, harmony within their staff. They possess more reliability on staff. They possess team building within the staff. And it is only possible for those firms where maturity level of people is really very high. This is called as star network or all channel network. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. All the 5 are mutually connected. And above all, everybody is connected to everyone. That means I can convey my thoughts freely to each and everybody present in the situation. This is all about communication networks and their types. Let us proceed further. Now, this is the most important thing of communication, giving and receiving feedback. Why feedback is so important? I would like to convey with an example. I conveyed my younger brother that, my dear, I studied this chapter, please pick the underlines and type them. Underline nikal kar type kar dein. Pick the underlines and type them. I went to my office, I came back, I asked my brother, my dear, have you prepared the draft, have you typed the thing? He said yes. When I saw the draft, it was not having a single underline within it. Why? Why there was no single underline? My brother thought that he is supposed to type only those things other than the underline. Because I said, underline nikal ke type kar dena. I said, pick the underlines and then type them. I wanted to convey something. He understood something else. That means feedback was not provided. I would have asked him, my dear, you have understood what I wanted to say? Have you understood what I wanted to say? If yes, then it's good. If no, please tell me again. But there is a big but in between. We cannot ask for feedback from everyone. I can ask for feedback from my juniors. I can ask for feedback from my colleagues. But can I ask my senior, sir, have you understood it or not? I cannot. Therefore, we can take and receive feedback from our juniors and peers, but we cannot try to have feedback. We cannot ask for feedback from our seniors. Therefore, this should be taken care of. Let us proceed. Now comes choice of communication channel richness. Richness word itself means the amount of information that can be transmitted during a communication process. This is the communication process. I am conveying my thoughts to you all. What is the degree of communication? What is the degree of thought that I have floated in your minds? Am I able to give it in a better way? Is this a rich channel? You might have seen certain advertisements having certain emotional appeals. Why they use such appeals? Why television is much more effective than radio? And why radio is far more effective than some other things like this? Only one reason: media and its richness. We should try to evaluate it. There are certain characteristics of rich channels. That means how effectively you can reach the person. Immediately the person should feel, oh, I have seen it. This is called as impact of communication channel richness. Three characteristics of rich channels. Number first, handle multiple cues simultaneously. That means lot many things are involved. Presently, I am conveying my thoughts to you. I would have conveyed in a reading form also. Why I am not reading? If I merely read this lecture, what will happen to you? You will feel bored. If I only study without these PowerPoint presentations, there is no presentation, the richness will be deteriorated. That means handle multiple cues. This media, this PowerPoint, computers, I am speaking, all these things are conveyed to enhance the richness of communication. The second is facilitate rapid feedback. I want rapid feedback. People said, this car, wonderful car with the best mileage. Indians are very crazy about mileage. The advertisement speaks about this. Why the advertisement speaks about this? Because really, people want more mileage. That means effective feedback, quick feedback should be there from the people for whom you are speaking. And third one, are very personal in context. Personal context means it should touch the things by heart. It must not be superficial. Superficial communication doesn't create an impact on society or on an individual. It should be there through your heart, because communication and leadership both starts from within, intrinsic through heart. Now let us talk about information channel richness of communication channels. In this diagram, we have plotted from low channel richness to high channel richness. Friends, we talk about formal reports, formal bulletins, memorandums, letters. They all are written in form. I cannot give you immediate feedback after studying or reading a letter. I cannot give you immediate feedback or reaction after reading a report. Therefore, we say this communication possesses low channel richness. It is not very rich. Secondly, pre-recorded speeches or electronic mails. Pre-recorded speeches means the speech that has been recorded and it has been telecasted. This is also having some more weightage in comparison to letters, memos and reports, but not up to that extent in which there is video conferencing or direct face-to-face conversation. Email, this is also having an impact, but above all, not that much like verbal or general communication. Online discussions, group discussions, voicemail, they are far better than the previous one, that is letters, memorandum and pre-recorded speeches, but not as good as video conferencing or one-to-one face-to-face conversations. Live speeches. This is a live speech I am demonstrating in front of you. There is no addition in particular speech. live speeches also have a good mark on society. General direct speaking, you might have seen some programs on television in which there is direct recording, live, they are telecasted on a live basis. That creates more impact than the previous one. Telephonic conversations, they are also very fruitful because you listen to the person just sitting nearby you. Video conferencing, video calling, you might be knowing about 3G calls recently, and above all, face-to-face conversations, they are having high channel richness, they are very rich while communicating our thoughts. So this is all about communication channel richness. Now let us summarize this session. In this session, we studied the impact of grapevine on organizations, usefulness and problems related to grapevine communication, and why and how grapevine can be used strategically has been conveyed through this lecture. We also studied communication channel richness and different modes of conveying your thoughts in front of others. We also studied the impact of feedback and how feedback can play a vital role while conveying your thoughts. This is what we have studied in this session. In next session, we will study different types of communications, that is assertive, aggressive, and passive communication. Thanks a lot.